Today, we're going to make some misty mountains. Let's take a look at our reference material, the beautiful, charming, hand-drawn map of Christopher Tolkien's in his father's book, The Lord of the Rings. These mountains are heavy with ink, and like maps of the 18th and 19th centuries, they represent mountains more as boundaries than as literal terrain. Oh, look, chickens. Anyway, there's a pretty strong verticality to the position of these mountains. They're tightly clustered in the X dimension and have a little bit more breathing room in the Y dimension. I'm just gonna draw a little mountain asset in Photoshop that we can use in ArcGIS Pro to populate our mountain areas. I'll start out with a little cluster of mountainy shapes, somewhat overlapping each other, and then I'll ink in their shaded sides, and I'll just sketch in some quick texture in the illuminated areas, and then finally I'll just pencil in some dusty looking shadows. Now you may or may not be comfortable drawing your own graphics from scratch, so anything I've made, I'll provide a link to. But I also learned a lot about how to draw fantasy maps from my friend Wes Jones. Definitely check out his series of books, and thank me later. And finally, here we are in ArcGIS Pro, and I can turn on my paper textures from Living Atlas, the forest style that we worked on in the previous video, and I have a mountains layer. And let's open up the symbology panel for these mountains. I'm going to go into the structure tab and I'm going to add a symbol layer called marker layer. And that's all I need. I can go ahead and get rid of the stroke and the fill symbol layers. And I'll go back into the symbol layers tab. Now, instead of a shape marker, I'm going to use a picture marker. And this just lets me use any digital image that I have on my computer as the marker symbol. I'll navigate to the one we just made. I'll increase its size to 28 points so that we can see it. And yikes, instead of fixed, I'm going to choose random placement. And then I'll give them some breathing room. 60 points in the X dimension and only 20 points in the Y dimension. This gives us that sinuous verticality that we see in the book. But the way they get trimmed off at the edges breaks the look, so I'm going to choose remove if center is outside the boundary of the polygon. Now, instead of a white background for these mountains, I'd like them to inherit the same color as the khaki background. So I'll use the tint property, which has the cool effect of painting in any white pixel with the color of your choice. But I still wouldn't mind some highlights on this image, so I'm going to go back into my original file and pencil in some white highlights and then hide all the mountain layers and export a second image, this one just highlights. And then in Pro, I can go into the structure tab and just duplicate this. And for this topmost version, I'm going to browse to my new mountains highlight layer and hit OK, and I'll undo my tint, setting it back to white. Now my mountains are misty. But because I'm just using that one mountain image, it looks a little clone stampy. So I'll just make another little mountain. This one's like a foothill, it'll be smaller. And just like before, I'll save it as a PNG with a transparent background. And in Pro's symbology panel, I'm going to duplicate my original mountains and I'll switch out this file for the other file. And I want it to be smaller, so I'll shrink its size down to 12 points. But right now, all my little hill graphics are perfectly covered up by the mountain graphics, so I'll need to re-roll the dice on this seed value for the randomization. And then I'll change its spacing so that it's more common horizontally than vertically. And now I can see those little hills poking out from behind the mountains. This fills in nicely and adds variability. And just like I did with the mountains, I'm going to create a highlight graphic and export this as a separate PNG and add it to the layer. And just like before, I'll duplicate my symbol layer and then I'll switch out the graphic to this new graphic and I'll remove that tint so it stays white. And because we all know that mountains are the bosses of forests, I'm going to drag mountains on top of the forest layer so it renders right. And then, well, actually that's it. We're done. We just used custom PNG images as marker symbols to fill polygons in ArcGIS Pro and make a map that looks like it's ripped from the pages of a fantasy book. Well, I lied. We're not totally done. We've just done all that work and we don't want to lose it. So I'm going to save this to our style so it can be easily applied to any polygon in this project or shared with your map nerd friends. Creating a new style and populating it is easy. Check out the end of my previous video about how to do that. I hope you'll join me for the next video where we'll talk about water.